I'm backstage with Tial Thang. Congratulations on a win tonight. You got the decision victory. I got to talk a little bit about the second round. Okay, you had a beautiful leg kick and a straight left that hurt him. Did you think maybe you were going to be able to get it done that round?
Yeah, I absolutely, like I said before the fight, I was going to look for the finish the whole round, but unfortunately I let it go. It's just I'm going to take as a lesson learned, and the next fight I'm going to be sharper.
Well, it's always easier said than done. Everybody wants to finish, but when you have somebody tough in there, you know, sometimes it's not so easy to get done. So it's okay. It was still highly entertaining. And, you know, another thing I noticed was that Myanmar seemed to be in Kuala Lumpur. Was it just me, or was the crowd just, it just seemed like there was a lot of support for you, maybe specifically from Myanmar?
Before I answer your question, I want to thank all the Myanmar fans to come out and support me. And everywhere we go, we are allowed and we are proud to represent our flag, and that's the way we are.
Yeah, I definitely felt a presence here, and I saw the Myanmar flag, so that was pretty neat to see. You're in the third round. I saw you were using a little bit of a different tactic in that you were like faking your shot, or you're faking your movement, and then it would draw out the shot on him. Was that something maybe that the corner told you, or did you just kind of realize that if you can get that shot out of him out of the way, you could damage with knees and everything else, punishing him on the way back out?
So the third round, the same game plan, but I don't know what to say. It's just the way I fight, I guess. Fake in, make him come in. But when he come in, I back out. So it's a lesson learned for me. And like, just the back corner, my brother say, I fake in good, but I don't give it back. So my next fight, will be different.
Well, I have to close with this. I mean, you had a pretty stellar corner. You had Aung Lan Song and Martin Nguyen in your corner. You talked a lot about how, you know, that's almost a dream come true, just to have such champions in your corner, such good advice. And I did see you, but you know, in the middle of the rounds, looking to your corner to get that advice. So tell me maybe what it was like to have them in your corner.
You know, you only dream of it, and you only see this kind of stuff in a movie. So I get to live the movie in a reality. So I have nothing to say, but it is a blessing for me. So thank you very much for Martin and Aung Lan to be in my corner, and also my good friend Keith from Australia. So It was an honor and a blessing for me.
Well, Tial, congratulations on a great victory tonight. We look forward to whatever's next for you. Thanks for taking a moment.
Thank you very much.
Well, Aung Lan, Martin, I am backstage with you guys after a successful cornering job tonight. Your boy, Tial Thang, did a great job. He won a three-round decision against a very game opponent. Aung Lan, I'll start with you. Like, what did you think of his performance?
I think he stayed composed. I would like to see a little bit more, but there were some certain stances that happened to him, you know, during training camp and stuff. But I think for the most part, he fought well, you know, for his second pro fight. There's a lot more that's going to come out of him for sure.
Hmm. Martin, what was the game plan going into this?
The game plan was to just beat his opponent in every division. Any situation that occurred, we beat a better person in those positions. And you know what, Tial trained his heart out this camp, and hats off to his opponent. Very tough guy. Tial had a perfect performance, but it can be better.
Yeah, so you said it. I mean, he beat him in every area, right? So I mean, I think we can take that away. He did a really good job there, but there's always room to improve. So from both of you guys, I mean, what do you expect to see coming forward from Tial?
I expect a better pressure next time, better pressure on the feet, and then more damage when he's on the ground, be a little bit more active. I would like to see him, you know, posture up and do actual damage on the ground and pound.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely. I would like to see Tial put a lot more pressure on his opponents, but yeah, depending on circumstances, and go from there. I mean, tonight I can't really fault him. He really listened to his corner, and he really trained hard for this fight, and everything. We got what we came for. Sorry.
Well, with talking to him earlier, he did say how much it meant to have you both in his corner. So I'm sure if you're both saying the same thing, we will see a lot more pressure coming from him in the future. In closing, I got to ask you guys about Myanmar here. It was just crazy because we're in Kuala Lumpur, and I kind of felt like we were in Myanmar, right? Yeah. Did you notice that?
No, for sure. The 600,000 Burmese in Malaysia, I want to be here. next Malaysia event, I want to be here, and I want to fight for the fans.
I don't think anybody's going to disagree with that.
Nah, I'm going to fight here before him.
Great. Well, thanks for taking a minute, guys.